You know, in the end of this sharing, I can promise you guys one thing.
你知道在这个今天的分享结束的时候, 我会确保大家一件事情。
Hello, all of you will go very hungry after this.
每个人都会很饿的。
Look at the time right now.
你看看时间。
How am I going to share my message this morning?
我怎样去分享我今天早上的这个主题呢?
But it's okay, you guys are not coming here for the lunch, right?
你来了不是为了午餐的。
Anyone of you are coming for the lunch?
有人来是为了午餐吗?
So it's okay, we're coming here for the word of God, right?
所以我们来这里是为了神的话语。
So this morning, let's just quiet our hearts and let's come before the Lord and let's prepare our hearts and let me just pray before I start.
所以让我们今天早上就安静我们的心来到神的面前，我们预备我们自己，让我们一起来祷告。
Father, this morning, I just want to commit, Lord, the congregation onto your hand. Father, whatever things that you have given me, Lord, may go out your words with power, Lord, like a double-edged sword, Lord. They were able, Lord, to be fruitful, Lord, and they were able to cut through heart, Lord. They will repent and they will see, Father, your goodness, Lord. You are a good God. Father, I pray that you speak to each one of us. It will be a blessing, Father, and not a curse, Lord. That they will be blessed by the message. Father, may the blood of Jesus Christ protect each one of us, cover each one of us. In Jesus' most precious name, Father, I commit this time unto your hand. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Are you guys ready?
大家准备好了吗?
Tell your neighbors beside you, I will put on my seatbelt right now.
告诉你隔壁的人，你现在要系好你的安全带。
Because we're going to rush through it a bit.
因为我们需要讲得快一点。Okay,
but it's okay. It's okay to be late. Yeah, let me get this right. Okay, now
Anan.
Okay. So this morning we're going to start with the book of Deuteronomy.
所以今天早上我们要讲的是《生命记》.
And to be specific, it's in book of Deuteronomy chapter 9-11.
所以我们今天特别要讲的就是《生命记》的第9到11章.
So if you read through the book of Deuteronomy chapter 9,
如果你去读这个《生命记》的第9章,
it's a bit about Moses preparing the people to enter into the Jordan.
所以这个地方大概就是摩西在预备那些人去到这个约旦.
But before they enter into Jordan, they said stop.
但他们到进约旦之前，他们讲说停一下.
I want to tell you a grandfather story first.
我要告诉你一个古老的故事.
I want to tell you something that is very important before you enter into Jordan.
在你进入到约旦之前，我要告诉你一件非常重要的事情.
So as we start reading the book of Deuteronomy chapter 1, you will see that Moses is preparing them.
所以当我们去读《生命记》的第一章的时候，我们可以看见约这个摩西在预备他们.
And as you read through it, they start to play all this black and white footage.
所以当他们去讲的时候，他们整个的过程你会看到很多的黑白的，好像这种电影胶片在讲。
So let's next page. Okay, Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 1. Here is Israel. You are about to where? To about to cross the Jordan. Go in and dispose a nations greater and stronger than you with large city that have walls up to the sky.
所以这里讲到说，以色列啊，你当听，你今日要过约旦河，进去赶出比你强大的国民，得着广大坚固、高得顶天的城邑。
And the Anakites, and you know about them, and they, you have heard it. Who can stand against the Anakites? But be assured today, right now, that the Lord your God is the one who goes across ahead of you. Like a devouring fires, he will destroy them and will subdue them before you, and you will drive them out and annihilate them quickly, as the Lord has promised you.
那名是亚纳族的人又高又大，是你所知道的。也曾听见有人指着他们说：“谁能在亚纳族人面前站立得住呢？”你今日当知道，耶和华你的神在你面前过去，如同烈火要灭绝他们，将他们制服在你面前。这样你就要照耶和华所说的赶出他们，使他们速速灭亡。
So Moses is telling them, guys, before you enter into Jordan, I'm going to tell you, you know, like you, I'm preparing you guys. Those guys that you're facing in front of you, they are like giants.
所以在这里，摩西就告诉那些人说：“当你要进入约旦之前，我要先预备好你。你要知道，你所面临的人是那些很高大的巨人。”
In fact, physically, they are really giants. They are really tall.
因为你如果看到那些亚纳族人，他们是真的很高大。
But God said that, "Don't worry, I will prepare you guys."
但是神说不用担心，我会预备你们。
I myself Yahweh will come before you and destroy your enemies.
我耶和华会帮助，会来到你的面前，帮你去毁掉这些的敌人。
And he continued, he reminded the people, verse 4, after the Lord your God has driven them out before you, do not say, remember this, do not say to yourself, the Lord has brought me here to take the possession of this land because of my righteousness.
耶和华你的神将这些民众从你面前撵出以后，你心里不可说：耶和华将我领进来这地是因我的义。
It's not because of your righteousness or your integrity that you are going to take the possession of their land.
因为并不是因为你的义，或者是因为你自己的原因，而让你可以拿到了这样的一块土地。
Understand then that it is not because of your righteousness that the Lord your God giving you this good land to possess. You are a what?Sniff-neck, means stubborn people.
因为你们是那些的景，你应着景象的百姓，并不是因着你们的义，也不是因为你的心理正直而给你这片的土地。
Oh, for three times Moses tell that, you know, you guys, when the Lord delivers you and enter into the land of Jordan, it's not because how good you are.
所以在这里有三次的时间，摩西有提醒这些人，神拯救你们去约旦，并不是因为你们有多好。
It's not how good or how powerful you are, how strong you are, but because it's not because of your righteousness, but God delivers you.
并不是因为你有多么的强壮，或者并不是因为你的义，而是因为神拯救了你。
Because what? Because you guys are stubborn nations.
因为你们是一些硬着景象的百姓。
You are stubborn people.
你们是一些很固执的人。
So in verse 7, he said, Remember this and never forget how you aroused the anger of the Lord your God in the wilderness. From the day you left Egypt until you arrived here, you have been what? Rebellious against the Lord. At Horeb, you aroused the Lord wrath, so that he was angry enough to destroy you.
所以接下来讲到说，你当纪念不忘你在旷野怎样惹耶和华你神发怒，自从你出了埃及地的那日，直到你们来到这地方，你们时常悖逆耶和华。你们在何烈山又惹耶和华发怒，他愤怒你们，要灭绝你们。
So what happened in Horeb?
所以在何烈山发生了什么呢？
If you guys are first time in church or you do not know the story, let me give you a simplified version.
所以如果你是第一次来到教会，或者你不知道这段经文的话，让我给你一个简单的版本。
Moses are leading a group of people, close to 600,000 people, out from Egypt, cross the Red Sea.Miraculously, with supernatural, and enter in and wandering in the wilderness.
所以当啊耶这个摩西其实他带领了大概600,000的人离开了埃及，穿过红海，在行了神迹之后，进入到这个旷野当中。
And when they reach this place called Horeb,
当他们来到何烈山的时候
，Moses has an appointment with God in the Mount Sinai.
那摩西就和神有这样的一个约定，是在西奈山。
So Moses left this group of people in Horeb.
所以摩西就把这群人留在了何烈山。
And went out for 40 days and 40 nights.
那他就去了40个日夜。
And while Moses is up in the mountain,
当摩西在这个山上的时候
，When the people saw the mountain, they were like this cloud and fires, and they know that the presence of God is there.
当他们看到这些云和火在山上的时候，他们知道神有显现给摩西。
And for 40 days and 40 nights, Moses is in the mountain. You know, God was chatting with him and then preparing the tablets. You know, the Ten Commandments.
所以在那四十天的时间里面，四十天的昼夜，神就与摩西在讲话，去预备那些的约柜啊，还有那些约板。
But while Moses are on the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights,
当摩西在这个山上四十天日夜的时候
，Those people at Horeb they were like start anxious already.
那在何烈山的这些人就开始紧张了。
They will start questioning, asking themselves.
他们开始自己问
：“Hey, you can survive 40 days without eating? 啊？
你不吃东西四十天可以活吗？
可以吗？
可以吗？” Can
四十天不用喝水可以吗？
40 days without drinking anything.
Cannot, right?
不可以的。
死了啦 ！Moses is dead, and all of them start to get panic.
所以那些人，所有的人就变得很紧张。
Where is Moses? You know?
摩西在哪里呢
？Our leader.
我们的领袖。
He led us out from Egypt.
他把我们从埃及带了出来。
He went up to the mountain and is gone.
然后他去了山上不见了。
Don't you guys are anxious about it?
你们不会觉得紧张吗？
To get panic,
他们所有人就开始变得非常的紧张不安。
And then they get Moses' brother. Hey, brother, Aaron, come here.
所以他们就叫亚伦过来。
What are we going to do?
然后就问亚伦，我们怎么办呢
？We stuck here.
我们就在这里困住了。
We left Egypt and we give up everything. We stuck here, and your leader is up on the mountain and he's nowhere to be found.
我们放弃了所有东西，从埃及离开，现在我们找不到我们的领袖。
And I think he's gone.
我们以为他不见了。
So what happened?
所以接下来发生什么呢
？Aaron gathered all the people.
所以亚伦就聚集了所有人。
Don't panic.
不要担心, 不要紧张。
Give me all your gold first.
把你所有的金子给我。
Let me melt it.
让我把它们融掉。
And I will prepare and carve this golden calf.
那我会去准备一个金牛。
And this is your new God.
这是你新的神。
You gather and worship him.
我们一起来,
this calf, this idol.
敬拜这个金牛。
While all this thing is happening,
但所有的这些事情在发生的时候,
God is telling Moses,
那神就在告诉摩西,
hey, you guys, you know, those people who you bring up from the wilderness, they are worshipping idols.
你知道那些你带来旷野的这些人,他们在敬拜别的神。
And Moses carrying the tablets and coming down from a mountain, when he saw this scene of people worshipping these calf idols, he was so furious.
当摩西他带着这些约板下到山下来的时候，看到所有人聚集在一起，在这里敬拜这个偶像的时候，
And in his anger, he threw down the Ten Commandments.
他非常的生气，他把这个十诫命的约板就扔掉了。
Immediately, the Ten Commandments broken.
那就约板就碎了。
And he said, "What are you guys doing?"
他就问你们在做什么？
Why are you worshiping a thing?
为什么你去敬拜这样的偶像？
And from there on, he crushed the golden calf.
所以在那个地方，他就毁掉了这个金牛。
He crushed it and make it like into a melo ping.
他把这个金牛就变成了粉末。
And ask each one of you, drink it.
让每一个人都喝掉这个东西。
And that's what happened.
这就是在何烈山发生了什么事情。
In Herod.
在何烈山。
Because Moses said, do you know that the things you are doing right now,
那摩西就说：“你知道你现在所做的事情，
God can destroy you immediately.
神可以立刻毁灭你们所有人，
because of your action of worshiping other idols.
因为你们在敬拜别的神。
And so we go through. This one is the golden calf story, by the way.
所以这个就是那个金牛的故事。
And this morning we're going to share about Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 11. It's like a story, you know, about the grandfather story lah. You can see the black and white film coming back where the Moses prepared them before they enter into Jordan.
所以今天我们在学习的《申命记》第九到第十一章，就是摩西在预备他们好像是旧时候的一个电影影片，一遍遍的通过。
So we're going to share about the history of the Israel stubbornness in the wilderness.
所以我们需要跟大家分享的就是这个以色列人在这个旷野当中他们的这个固执。
How many of you think you are stubborn? Can I show your hand?
有多少人觉得自己是一个固执的人？
快了，快一点啊！
有不少人这样觉得。
Yesterday when I share with my wife asked me, you know, what are you preparing? I said, I'm preparing Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 11.
所以昨天的时候我太太就问我你在准备什么，我说我就在准备申命记第九到十一章。
Wow, he said, wow, it seems quite a tough message to preach.
他就讲说，这段经文好像很难去跟大家讲到。
Yeah, I said, it's quite tough, but it's inspired by you.
我说对，是非常难，但是是你告诉我的。
He said, what is about the topic about it?
他就问，那你的主题是什么呢？
I said, stubbornness.
我讲关于固执。
This is why my wife is not here this morning.
所以今早我太太不在。
But it's not because she's angry, but she's serving in her church because it's a full time, so they are having a camp.
当然并不是因为她生气了，而是因为她在另外的她自己的教会，因为他们那边有一个营会。
So normally we know about this word stubbornness.
所以很多时候我们知道这个词固执。
It's one word, right?
它是一个词。
But you can put it into different phases, you know.
但是你可以把它放在不同的阶段。
And in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 11, you can see several phases about the word stubbornness.
所以你在生命记当中第九到十一章，你可以看到它不同阶段的这个固执。
So as I go through it, you try to spot, you know, try to spot, hey, which one are you?
但我们在讲的时候，你可以试着去找出来你是在哪一个阶段。
Because all of us are stubborn in some way or another in our life.
因为我们每一个人在我们的某一个部分可能都是很固执的。
But what is the opposite of stubbornness?
那固执的反义词是什么呢？
In this context, it's the fear of the Lord.
那在这个的环境当中，这个文章当中就是敬畏神。
Before, I want to start with this my points.
那在开始之前，我想要先用这个来开始。
I want you guys to wear a lens.
我希望你们戴上一个眼镜。
You're wearing a lens, right? I want you to wear a lens, different perspective to see things differently.
我希望你们戴上眼镜，可以从不同的角度来看事情。
You know, 100 to 200 years ago, where they have this circus, where they have all these freak shows.
你知道，如果在一百两百年前的时候，在这个马戏团有很多的这种表演。
Where they have this big cloth and this big cage, right?
你知道他们有一个大大的笼子，外面罩着一个很大的布。
And inside the cage, they have all these weird people.
那在这个笼子里面有那些很奇奇怪怪的人。
Do you know what I'm talking about? These freak shows.
你们知道吗？就是这种的怪兽表演。
Some people are tall, like 7 feet, 8 feet. Some of them are so heavy. Some of them have 4 legs.
就是那种有一些人可能很高，有些人可能很壮，有些人可能就是有四条腿啊。
And people will take out the cloth.And they said, I present to you the monstrous woman from Virginia, you know, the beard woman, the woman with beard.
所以当然他们就可能揭开那个
that kind of freak shows, yeah.
揭开那个布的时候就说我向大家来展示这个可能有胡子的女生啊或者这样一些奇奇怪怪的人这样的一些演示。
And then people say, whoa, when they saw this beard woman, they said, wow, they were amazed. And they would say, oh, it's so freaky, you know, and they move up to the next freak show.
所以他们就会讲说他们看到这些人就会有一个反应就哇这些人好奇怪然后你就去到下一个的表演。
Sometimes,
有些时候
when we read the book of Deuteronomy especially,
特别是当我们读生命记的时候
you feel that it's like a freak show. These guys, you know, in Israelites, they are like freak, you know.
你会看到这些人觉得他们很奇怪你好像在看这种奇怪的表演
Where got people, you know, lead up from supernatural and you will in suddenly they turn away from God and they will make this calf, you know, and they will drink and all this is so freaky.
为什么会有这样子的人？就是他们看到了这些神迹之后，他们还是去向神去抱怨，而且还见了这个金牛，他们很奇怪。
You tell yourself, if I'm there, I will not abandon God.
所以你会告诉自己，如果我在那里，我不会去背叛神。
Surely I will continue to worship Yahweh. You know, no way I'm going to abandon God.
我肯定会继续的去赞美、去敬拜神，我不会去背逆神。
But it's like a freak show.
但是好像那个怪人的表演。
A lot of time,
很多时候。
You really need to sit down.And look at the person intently.
你需要坐下来去仔细的看那个人。
This Annie Jones.
这个 Annie John.
Was born on 1865.
所以他是在1965年的时候出生的。
And since young, this one is a real story.
这是一个真实的故事。
And since young, like 3 years old, he started having beards already.
从很小的时候，三岁开始他就有胡子了。
And he was got so famous, and some people even kidnapped her, you know, to bring to another freak shows.
那他就变得非常的有名那很多人就把他可能带去不同的这种怪人的表演
she passed away at age 37, very young.
他很年轻37岁就去世了
When people saw this Annie, wow, it's so freaky, you know, it's so weird, you know, what is this guy, you know, it's like a monster.
所以很多时候人看到这个人就会讲、哦、这个人好奇怪啊你看他又有胡子好像一个女生他好像一个怪兽一样
But if you intently look into this picture or when you imagine yourself during the freak show, you know, you look into her eyes
如果当那个时候你真的是在这样的一个表演的时候你看进她的眼睛
You try to see her pain
你试着去看她的痛苦
You try to see her loneliness
你可以看到她的孤独
When you see her cries behind the bars
当你看到他在那个笼子后面哭的时候
Then you start to realize that she's more like you.
那你会发现他其实更像你
She's just a human.
他只是一个人
So as we gaze into Israel, as we read the book of the Old Testament, you know, especially the book of Deuteronomy.
当我们去看去以色列人，当我们去读这个旧约，特别是看到这个生命记的时候
There are a lot of things common with us, you know.
那有很多事情对我们来说也是很一致的
So this morning, I want you to wear the lens of.To look when you read the book of Deuteronomy.
所以我希望你今天早上读生命记的时候可以带这样的一个镜片。
When you look and you see this Israelites doing all these crazy things, actually, it's actually quite close to us.
当你看到在生命记里面所记录的这些人做这些疯狂的事情的时候，其实跟我们是息息相关的。
So stubbornness comes in many forms.
因为我们的固执可能来自于不同的方式。
And because of time, I will go to the first form.
所以因为时间关系，我们现在来到第一个。
What happened in the area, in this place called Horeb?
就是在何烈山发生了什么
？People start to get impatient.
那些人开始变得没有耐心。
As I mentioned, when the anxiety kicks in, right, you do a lot of crazy things.
因为当那些焦虑来袭击的时候，你做都很多的这种疯狂的事情。
Imagine 6,000 old people left Egypt and stranded in this place, Horeb.
你想一下，大概有600,000的人从埃及离开之后，就卡在了这个何烈山这里。
And the leader is gone.
然后那个领袖不见了。
For 40 days, it's gone. You know, it's gone.
40天你找不到那个领袖。
Everyone start to get panic.
每个人都开始变得很紧张。
What are we going to do?
我们要做什么呢
？We're going to look for a new God.
我们要找一个新的神。
Sometimes it happens to us too, right?
有时候我们也会发生在我们身上。
When everything got so silent, you say, "Oh God, where are you?"
当一切事情变得很安静的时候，你也会问神你在哪里。
But people make bad choices when they are impatient.
但是当这些人在他们没有耐心的时候，他们做了错误的决定。
It's like same as King Saul when we shared a few months ago.
好像几个月前我们所讲的这个扫罗王。
Because of his impatience.
因为他没有耐心
he fall to sin.
所以他就犯罪
Same as the people, the Israelites here, when because of their impatience, they're not willing to wait, they don't have the faith in God, they start committing sins.
所以就像这些以色列人，因为他们没有耐心，没有耐心去继续的等待神，所以他们就开始犯罪
You know, a quick one, you know, sometimes when you pray for patience, right?
有时候你祷告，你为了耐心而祷告。
A lot of funny, funny things will start happening.
那一切很有趣的事情就会发生。
You know, this morning my colleagues is here, Desmond.
今天早上我的同事 Desmond 在这里。
Say hi, Desmond.
Hi, Desmond.
Finally, he's.
欢迎回来。
So when Desmond is in the same life group with me, every Tuesday doing devotions.
所以每个星期二我们会有一起的查经。
So my boss, right? My boss, he said, "Hey, I need to have more patience."
那我老板就说：“哎呀，我需要更多的耐心。”
Because he knows his personality is D, right? D-I-S-C is D. He's very rush. He make very impatient person.
所以，因为知道他自己的这个本身的性格，就是一个非常没有耐心的这种性格。
So he said, "Okay, boss, we're going to pray for you. Everyone pray for boss. You know, the once we pray for him, for God, give our boss patient."
所以那时候我们就一起来说是，老板，我们来为你祷告，就让求神给你这样的耐心。
And things start happening.
那事情就开始发生了。
Every Tuesday when we have morning devotions.
每个星期二早上，当我们有这个早上的一起的祷告的时间
，His driver will come missing.
他就不见了。
He's still sleeping, you see.
他还在睡觉。
But throughout the week, it's okay. But just on Tuesday morning devotions.
所以其实每一天早上都可以的，就是到晨祷的那天早上
，He will be late.
他就会迟到。
And a lot of things happen on that morning devotion, you know.
所以每次晨祷的时候，就早上他那里都会发生很多事情。
And my boss said, God is testing me. I need to be patient.
那老板就想说，我的老板就说啊，神一定是在试探我，我一定要有耐心。
Because every single time there's these things, there's hurdles in front of him, he was reminded God is training him.
因为每一次当有这种事情在他的面前的时候，就在想神在训练我。
And last time when we entered into our new building,
所以最近的时候是我们进到我们的这个新的建筑。
Of all the people taking the new lift.
所有的人都用那个新的电梯。
For so many months, we're using the lift.
因为很多个月，我们都在用这个电梯。
During the morning devotion, he's the one who's stuck in the lift.
所以在早上晨祷的时候，他是那个就卡在电梯里的人。
Not only that he's stuck in the lift, the security because of less of manpower, the security do not gone away already. So he was stuck inside dark and everything. You see.
他就卡在了那个电，他困在那个电梯里面，因为那个警卫也是因为人手不够，他们也不在，所以他整个就是黑在那个电梯里面。
And if not, that's Desmond see him hearing, oh, there's someone shouting or something. He will left there for hours and hours, I think.
如果 Desmond 不是 Desmond 听到他在里面这个喊叫的话，可能他要在里面很多个小时。
But we are all panic, you see, as employees, we are all panic. He says, 谁了谁了 this time, you know, God, we're gonna get, you know, scolded as stuff like that.
所以作为员工的话，我们都会觉得哇，惨了，那我老板一定会骂我们的。
But when the doors open, when we save him, finally we save him. The doors open, he came out.
所以最后，当我们真正打开这个门，他出来的时候，
哇 ，He seems so peaceful.
他看上去很平安。
He said, "You know, God is testing me."
他说神在试探我。
The first thing he said, "God is testing me. I need to be very patient."
所以第一件事他讲说神在试探我，我一定要耐心。
I think he really passed the test.
我想他真的是通过了这个试探。
Because inside the lift, if I'm not mistaken, he also read the Bible a bit. You know the words. He sit down on the floor, all dark. You see, everything is dark, pitch dark. He just open his and he can't call out because there's no line. He just sit there and just wait.
所以如果没记错的话，在那个电梯里的时候，他就是坐在那边去打开他的圣经来看，因为在电梯里面也是没有讯号的，没有办法打电话求救。
So this morning when you pray for patience or you pray for anything and things happen, don't freak out.
所以当今天早上你去祷告要求神给你耐心或者给你其他东西的时候，当有事情发生，你不要担心。
God is preparing you.
神在预备你。
Tell your neighbor beside you, God is preparing you.
告诉你隔壁的人，神在预备你。
And the second place that they went is Tabera.
第二个阶段就是他们所在的这个塔贝拉。
And in Tabera, they start on complaining. They start complaining already now.
在塔贝拉的时候，他们就全部人开始投诉。
And they complain and they complain about the hardship.
他们就抱怨他们所有的这个困难。
And God sent a fire and burned around the outskirts of their camp.
所以神就有了这个降下来这个火，让他们的这个营的外围都烧掉了。
Wow, you tell to ask yourself, "Hey, cannot complain, man, Christian."
那你开始问你自己啊，我们作为基督徒不能去抱怨呐、啊。
Can you complain?
我们可以抱怨吗
？Can you be angry?
你可以生气吗
？Can right?
可以。
God will not destroy you, right?
神不会毁掉你。
God said that I'm a very patient God.
因为神讲说我是一个有耐心的神。
In fact, in the book of Psalms, there's a whole chapter about the lamentation, right?
因为其实在这个诗篇当中有整一个一篇的这个诗篇是讲了关于这个哀痛的。
It's perfectly that you can express yourself in emotion. You say, God, I'm angry, I lament. It's okay, it's perfectly fine. But what happened here?
所以不管你有什么样子的情绪，你都可以发泄的出来，你可以告诉神。但是在这里发生了什么呢？
When you read at the book of Numbers chapter 10, you know the answers.
如果你去读民数记第十章，你就知道那个答案了。
You know, every single day since they walked out from the Red Sea,
从他们从红海出来之后，每一天的早晨，每一天
they are experiencing supernatural things that God is with them.
所以他们每一天都在经历那些超自然的事情，证明神与他们同在。全部都是超自然的事情。
You must imagine, let's recap back a bit. There were these guys, the Israelites, they are crying out, you know, for so many years in Egypt. Finally, God bring them out, perform supernatural things, open the Red Sea for them. They are experiencing supernatural things.
所以让我们就是回忆一点点的，就是因为那些以色列人很多年他们在埃及都在呼求神的拯救，那神把他们从埃及带出来之后，他们穿过了红海，经历了很多超自然的事情。
And it's so cool that God lead them by how?Because there are 6,000 over people, ma. There's a pillar of cloud in front of them, directing them where the place to go.
所以那是一个非常神奇的事情，因为他们有六十多万的人，他们怎么去走呢？就是神在前面有一个云柱，让他们可以跟随着云柱一起走。
How cool is that, right?
是不是很奇妙的一件事情
？It's supernatural, right?
是不是一件超自然的事情
？And the wind will direct them.
那风就会去给他们这样的一个指向。
What is even more supernatural is during at night, there's even a pillar of fire directing them.
所以更加的奇妙的一个事情就是在晚上的时候它会有一个火柱才引导他们。
But when they experience, listen carefully church, when they experience supernatural things in their life,
但是要仔细听教会，当他们去在生命当中经历这些超自然的事情的时候，
and yet they complain,
但是他们还在抱怨，
that's the issue.
这个就是问题了。
That's the issue.
就是那个问题。
Because God said that I perform so much thing for you, and yet you still complain, youAnd you become so negative.
那因为神讲说我已经跟你看了这么多的神迹，但是你还是那么的消极，你就把你转向了一个消极的一面。
Don't look beside your wife or your husband, okay?
不要看你的先生或者太太。
I'm not talking about them.
不是讲他们。
But I'm talking about this story.
在这个故事里面。
When you see so many things happen in your life that God delivers you, God performs miracles in your life, and yet you turn around and say.Complaints after complaints.
所以你看到在这里，神做了非常多的事情去拯救他们，去行那些的神迹，一些超自然的事情，还是他们会转过身去抱怨。
That every of the supernatural things, the outcome they yielded nothing.
所以每一件超自然的事情，最终的结果并没有给他们任何的改变。
It's just negative and complaints. That's why God is furious.
所以只是一些消极的这样的一些的抱怨，所以神觉得非常的生气。
You know, I feel that why God is so furious because in the book of Revelation chapter 12 verse 11, it said that they triumph over Satan by the blood of who? The blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony.They do not love their life so much as their strength from death.
所以，因为在这个启示录第十二章讲到说，弟兄胜过他是因羔羊的血和自己所见证的道。他们虽至于死，也不爱惜性命。
So how do you overcome Satan?
所以你怎样去克服这个撒旦呢
？By the blood of the Lamb.
因为是因这羔羊的血。
And by the word of their testimony.
还有自己所见证的道。
Do you know that your testimony that God have for you, the testimony that God performed for you?As you proclaim, as you share, as you say, yes, God, you deliver me because I remembers you. And with the power, the blood of Jesus Christ, you can overcome Satan.
你知道，当你去分享，当你去跟大家去宣告，你因着神的原因，因着神的这个神给你的见证，因着你的经历去经历神的时候，其实神的宝血会帮助你去克服撒旦。
But all this testimony, great testimony that the Israelites.Have seen in Egypt where God depart the sea and perform all these miracles where they have free food, you know, from the sky and everything free, lah. Yet they still complain. That's the issue.
但这些以色列人，他们经历了所有神给他们的这些神迹，经历了这些见证的时候，不管是看到红海分开，他们穿过红海，还是其他的一些免费的食物，神给他们一切的东西，他们还是在抱怨。
God said that I'm so angry.
神说我非常的生气。
Because you do not see my faithfulness for you.
因为你没有看到我在你身上的信实。
Because I am preparing you guys as the new nations.
因为我在预备你成为一个新的国家。
Yet your testimony is that, I don't have any, you know, I cannot enjoy meat, I cannot eat cucumber lah, I have no sweet drinks lah, everything. This is your testimony. That's why God is so angry about it.
因为当那个时候，神在预备你成为一个新的国家的时候，你却一直在抱怨，我没有吃，我吃不到肉啊，我吃不到我想吃的东西，喝不到我想喝的东西。这个是你所回馈给神的。
Is God telling you anything?
神，我告诉你什么东西吗？
Maybe in your workplace.
可能在你的工作的地方。
Or your family.
或者你的家庭。
Or your relationship.
或者你的关系。
Long time ago, you pray to God. God, give me this. Give me this. Give me this.
可能很久以前，你去跟神祷告说：“神，给我这个，给我这个。”
And God supernaturally given it to you.
那神的这个超自然能力就给了你。
And open doors for you.
为你打开了门。
And now you complain, 哎呀，这个谁谁谁，哎 ，no good one 啊。
所以现在你现在祷告说这个不好。
Don't do that. Don't complain.
不要做这样的事情，不要去抱怨。
That's one of example, huh?
这是其中的一个例子。
So can we move on?
好，我们继续。
Are you guys listening today this morning?
你们还有在听吗
？Yeah. Okay. The third place they went to.
第三个地方他们去的。
Is Massa.
就是在玛莎。
In Massa, they were thirsty.
在马上的时候他们非常的口渴。
But to be fair, they're supposed to be very thirsty because they are in the wilderness.
那很正常，因为他们是在一个旷野当中，他们肯定会口渴。
But when you are thirsty, what do you do?
当你口渴的时候，你通常做什么呢？
You ask for water, right?
你肯定是要水。
Moses.
摩西。
水呢？
Where is the water?
Where is the water?
水在哪里？
搞了这么多东西，水呢？
You take so many, you have done so many things. Where is the water?
We are finished already. We are so thirsty.
我们已经喝完水了，我们很渴。
But instead of asking Moses where is the water,
但是他们没有去问摩西水在哪里。
They start to quarrel.
他们开始吵架。
Among the people, among the groups, and eventually up to end up in Moses' ears.
所以他们就他们当中的很多人就一起的在吵架，最后就是被摩西听到。
Instead of asking for water,
他们没有去要水。
They are stupid, like Moses, so stupid. Why go all the way out here without water?
真的想说，摩西，你真的很傻，你为什么让我们一路走出来都没有水喝的
？Moses didn't plan, man.
摩西都没有好好的计划吗
？Why bring us all the way here, no meat, no water?
为什么带到我们这带到这里也没有肉吃，也没有水喝，又那么热
？If I'm back then, even though I've suffered a bit of lashes from my leaders, at least I have a good news.
那起码在最后以前的时候，我做奴隶的时候，虽然我会被鞭打，但是我起码有好的东西吃。
Why you bring me all the way from Egypt and come up here without anything to drink?
你为什么把我们从埃及带出来，你都不给我们水喝
？Crazy, like you, Moses.
摩西，你真的是疯掉了。
Wow, keep on complaining.
一直在抱怨。
Keep on crawling.
一直在吵架。
Instead of asking for, just a water.
他们不是在要水。
In the book of James, it said that you desire but do not have, so you kill. It's something like this, right? You covet but you cannot get what you want, so you quarrel like them. Quarrel and fight lah. Quarrel and fight. The spirit of fighting, huh? You do not have because you do not ask God.
所以在雅各书这里讲到，你们贪恋还是得不着，你们杀害嫉妒又斗殴征战也不能得，你们得不着是因为你们不求。
Some of us quarrel, right, in the office.
有时候我们在办公室的时候也会有争吵。
Quarrel, God, 哎呀 ，that boss are idiot lah, didn't know how to raise my salary, didn't give me bonus lah, all this, all that lah. But maybe God just want you to ask, you know, boss, can you raise my salary? Ah, that's easy.
有时候我们可能就在争吵，我们就说神啊，我们的那个老板真的不好，他又不给我起工资，又不给我最后的年终分红。其实可能有时候神只是想让你去问。
And they start many fights.
啊，我们会有很多的争战。
But the Bible say that.You come before me, you ask, knock, and you shall what? Receive, knock and door shall be open for you, ask and you receive. You will ask for something good like a bread, your God will not give you a what? A stone, right? If you ask for something good, he will not give you a snake, right?
所以因为在圣经里面讲到你要去求你去求的时候神就会给你叩门神就会给你开门你去要食物的时候神不会给你石头你去要好的东西神不会给你条蛇
But when you ask and you do not receive it because it's out from your what? From your lustful desires that's why you do not get it
那有的时候你寻求你呼求的时候你不会得到是因为那些东西是来自你的欲望
So tell your neighbors beside you don't quarrel
所以告诉你隔壁不要吵架
Don't have the spirit of quarreling.
不要有这种吵架的灵在你的当中。
Because when you quarrel and you see supernatural things happen in your life, you're doing, you know, you're praying and you start quarreling, God do not desire that.
因为当你看到你的生命当中你所求不得的事情的时候，你有因为这些事情而争吵的时候，不是神想看到的。
Okay, next one. We are moving right on time. At Kibroth Hattaavah.
所以接下来我们要看到这个地方叫做基波罗哈特哈塔瓦。
It's about their appetite.
就是关于他们的食物。
They have gone for 40 days without any meat.
因为他们去了四十天都没有吃肉吃。
It's all vegan, you know, all the way.
全部都是素食在吃的。
Oh God, where is all this meat? Yeah.
他们会问主啊，我们的这些肉在哪里
？And they start quarreling again.
他们又开始吵架。
And they start complaining and complaining.
那他们就开始要去抱怨，又去抱怨。
Instead of asking God, they start complaining.
所以他们没有问神，而是去抱怨。
And God said, "You want meat, right?"
神说你们想要肉是吗
？You really want meat, right?
你真的想要肉吗
？I will send you so much meat that you can eat up food sarcastically, lah. You eat up so full that you will come out. You know, the meat will come out from every holes, lah, in your body.
所以那时候神就说到一个比较不好听的方式，就是我会把所有的肉都给你们吃，这样你们所有的地方都开始往外冒肉。
But God is angry, you see?
因为神是非常的生气的。
But so they are so happy, you know, oh, I'm so happy, you know, there's so many meat. But before the moment.When they're able to bite and swallow and even bite, right? God sent a plague, you know, and almost 3,000 people died.
所以他们就非常的开心。当神把这些肉给到他们的时候，但是当他们在吃之前，神就有了这样的一个瘟疫，让他们当中的很多人死掉。
But why is God so angry?
为什么神会这么生气呢
？It comes down because the way they ask and their attitude.
因为是他们问的方式还有他们的态度。
There is no spiritual maturity. It runs out of battery. There's no spiritual maturity in the way they act.
因为在他们的行为当中，我们看不到一个属灵的成熟。
They just know how to complain and complain.
他们就只是知道怎么不停的抱怨。
They just grumble.
他们只是在不停的吵架。
Even though they see the supernatural things happen in their life.
就算他们看到这些超自然的事情发生在他们的生活当中。
You know, Book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 13. A lot of us know this. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, right?
你知道在腓立比书第四章这里我们都知道一段经文是我们靠着加给我力量的凡事都能做。
Yeah, normally we use this verse, we use in our exam, you know, when we want to go work, we go for running, you know, for marathon, we use this, I can do all things through Christ to strengthen me.
所以很多时候当我们考试的时候还是我们去跑马拉松或者我们在工作当中我们都会去宣告这段的经文凡事都能做。
But actually you use it wrongly, you see. Because in the book,What Apostle Paul is saying that Philippians chapter 4 verse 13, he said that I know what it is to be in need. I know what it is to be in plenty. I've learned the secret of being content in every situation, whether I'm well fed or hungry, whether living in plenty or in want, I can do all things through Christ to strengthen me.
所以在腓立比书其实保罗这里讲的非常的清楚是我知道怎样处卑贱也知道怎样处丰富或饱足或饥饿或有余或缺乏随时随在我都得了秘诀我靠着那加给我力量的凡事都能做。
So as a Christian,
所以作为基督徒
the moment that you feel pain when the rubbers meet the road,
当真正的这个事情发生的时候你感受到这个痛苦的时候
you need to
你要学会去信实
trust God.Sorry, guys. I think the enemies do not want me to finish this. Oh, hallelujah. May the blood of Jesus Christ cover over us, okay? Let me continue this. So when you're facing all this, the attitude is very important. 所以你的态度是很重要。Let me do my best to translate. So your attitude is very important. So 神要我们的态度要很重要。Why is it? Why?Because Paul said that, you know, no matter you're hungry or you're well-fed, God is preparing you, you see. You need to have the attitude of giving thanks and be faithful.
保罗有讲到无论是饱足还是饥饿你都一定要给神这样子的赞美。
So God is furious to the Israelites because they do not have the concept. Because Israel is going to represent God. If this group of people do not have the right attitude to show other people thatYou are representing Yahweh, then who is going to represent? That's why God is angry about it.
神非常的生气，因为以色列人他们将来是要去代表神的这样的一群的人。如果他们都不知道怎样去象征、怎样去代表着这个耶和华，那他们这样子做是完全没有意义的。神非常的生气。
So let's do a short recap.
让我们有一个小小的回应。
There are many phases in stubbornness.
在我们的这个固执当中，有非常多的不同的阶段。
In Herod, there's impatient.
在何烈山是没有这个耐心。
Tarabe is complaining.
所以在Tarabe是有这个他们在投诉。
Masa is quarreling.
在马萨是他们的争吵。
In Kidron, Hadava is the appetite, is the lust for life.
就是在基伯罗哈塔瓦的时候，是他们没有这个的食物来吃。
But this is not the worst.
但这还不是最糟糕的。
The worst is at Kadesh Barnea.
那最糟糕的是在加底斯巴尼亚。
Where they have fear.
当他们有恐惧。
This is where God is the angriest.
这个就是神最生气的地方。
God said, I'm the angriest at this point.
那神说我在这个时候是最生气的。
我已经顶不到了。
I cannot.
I really want to destroy you guys.
我真的想毁，我真的想要毁灭你们。
What happened in Kadesh Barnea?
所以在这个加底斯巴尼亚发生了什么呢？
As they sent out 10 spies, you know, to the enemy territories.
所以他们就找了这十个探子，把他们这十个探子差派到他们的这个敌人所在的地方。
Two spies came back.
其中两个探子回来
and they carry this grape and say, "Wow, this place is amazing."
那他们就说这个地方是非常美妙的一个地方
Look at these grapes.
你看这个地方
这么大
So big.
And you imagine, you know, the grapes is so good. It is flowing with milk and honey. Everything is good. You know, God is preparing us for such a wonderful land. You know, we should go in and possess it.
你知道这是一个非常好的地方，是一个流奶与蜜的地方。这个是神所应许给我们的地方，我们应该去占有它。
And all these two spies, they say all these great things. You know, guys, get ready. Let's conquer it. You know, God is giving us a really good deal. You know, milk and honey and everything is good.
所以那两个探子就非常的开心，说我们要带领大家一起去到那个地方，因为那是神所应许给我们的非常好的地方。
But the rest of the ten, the rest of the spies, the eight spies.
那其他的八个探子。
He said, "Wow, 那个地方不可以啊。
They say, "Oh, that place cannot."
These guys are all so big; they're Anakites.
因为那些人都非常的大，像那些巨人。
If you saw this grape is so big, yeah.
如果你看到这个葡萄这么大
，Imagine how big is their hand.
你想想他们的手要多大
？If you saw the bread, the hands is so big. Imagine how big is their size.
如果你看看他们的手那么大，你想他们的这个身材要多大？不要进去。
谁谋上啊 ？If you go in, surely you die.
如果你进去的话，你一定是会死的。
And he influenced everyone.
所以这个就影响了所有人。
People say, "Better not go in."
所以那人说啊，我们最好别去了。
Let's not go in. The fear strikes them.
所以他们的恐惧就让他们不想要去。
And God say, "I'm the angriest at Kadesh Barnea."
所以神就说我在这个地方是最生气的。
Because I've performed so many miracles since the day you come up from Egypt, from the Red Sea to depart, and the pillar and the food that I provided, and the miraculous, you know, water out from the rock. Yet until now.It's just next door. You can able to receive the promised land. You just enter. Yet you still do not believe me. I'm the angriest here.
因为神说，我从你们离开埃及开始，我就一直在行神迹，从分开红海，让这个岩石有水，从不同的这些的神迹，让你们一路经历了这些神迹，你们还是不相信我。我现在非常的生气，你们马上就要进到应许之地了，你们就害怕。
So God is telling that you do not have faith in me.
因为神讲，你们在我这里没有信心。
You do not trust me.
你不相信我。
You saw all this supernatural, yet you saw all this goodness that I provided for you all these years. Yet you do not trust in me.
你看到我所有行的这些神迹，所有的这些超自然的事情，还是你不相信我。
This is the place that I'm the angriest.
这是我最生气的地方。
And because of this, they did not enter into the promised land.
所以也是因为这个事情，所以他们没有进到应许之地。
And this is what Moses tells the people before they enter into Jordan.
所以这个是摩西所告诉的那些人，他们在进入约旦之前的事情。
So Moses said that.
所以摩西讲，他们所有发生的这些事情，在何烈山。在何烈山的时候，他们没有耐心。他们抱怨。
In Kirob, Hatava, they have this appetite, you know, for food. And in Kadesh Barnea, they have fear.
哈塔瓦的时候，他们就为了这个食物而吵架；在加底斯巴尼亚的时候，他们又为了恐惧而在争吵。
So God, what is the summary before they enter? He said, "Remember this."
所以总结是什么呢
？Moses, after share all this grandfather story, remember this.
所以摩西在分享了所有这些故事之后，就跟他们讲。
And I think it applies to us too.
那我相信这个对我们来讲也是一样的。
Because some of us, We have been a Christian for very long times.
因为我们当中有些人可能已经成为基督徒很久了。
But we have forgotten when we are back in Egypt when we are struggling.
但是我们忘记了我们当时在埃及的时候我们的挣扎。
Some of us when we are back in Egypt when we are struggling, we say, God help me, I'm so poor. You know, God give me a job. God give me this and that. And God have given you the blessing.
那我们很多人可能就像我们在埃及的时候，我们在呼求神，我们很穷，我们需要钱，我们需要一份工作。当神真的给到你的时候，你有了这份恩典的时候
yes, ，Some of us are stubborn. We have this impatience.
但是我们很多人还是讲我们没有耐心。
Why didn't you promote me?
啊，你没有给我升职。
God, why didn't I have this and that? You look at the people, you know, they are driving other things, you know, Mercedes and stuff like that. God, where do you still remember me?
所以你看到那些人驾好车的时候，你说神，你还记得我吗
？And when God give open a new opportunity to youFear strike in and say, "I do not want to enter."
当神给你这些新的机会的时候，你会非常感到非常恐惧，说神，我不想要去接受。
So this morning, God is telling you anew as you enter into a new chapter in your life.
所以今天早上，神告诉你，当你进到你生命当中的一个新篇章的时候。
Verse 12. And now, Israel, what does the Lord your God ask of you but to fear the Lord your God?
所以在这里，神说：“以色列啊，现在耶和华你神向你所要的是什么呢？只要你敬畏耶和华你的神。
To walk in obedience to Him,
遵行他的道。
To love Him,
爱他。
To serve your God with all your hearts and with all your soul,
尽心尽性侍奉他。
And to observe the Lord your commands,
遵守他的诫命。
And decrees that I'm giving you today for your what? Your own good.
就是我今日所吩咐你的，为要叫你得福。
The opposite of stubbornness.
所以我们的这个。固执的反义词
is your full allegiance to trust God.
就是完全的信任神
To humbly bow down before the Lord.
谦卑的来到神的面前
And say, God, I trust you.
告诉神神，我相信你
No matter what happened in your life.
不管我生命当中发生了什么
No matter what things is going through when the rubber meets the road.
不管在这个事情发生的时候，不管有什么样子的一个结果
Lord, I will be patient.
神，我会有耐心
I will be patient and I will not complain.
我会有耐心，我不会去抱怨
Because you have set a good work for me at the start, you will finish it well.
因为在一开始的时候，你已经给我预备了最好的，你也会让我有一个好的结束。
I will stop quarreling with people.
我不会跟其他人争吵。
Instead, I will ask you directly.
而是我会跟你直接的去求。
I will not be appetite for the lust of life, you know, of the things, but I will seek your will.
我不会因为生命的欲望而去求东西，主要而是因着你的意愿而求。
And no longer I will fear for things that is in front of me, but I will fear you, God.
我不再会恐惧在我面前的事情，主要我会去敬畏你。
So this morning, church.
所以今天早上
as I was finishing my stories here,
当我在完成我的这个讲完这个故事的时候
as we are about to enter into the new year,
当我们也差不多要进到新年了
some of you might have, God is preparing for a new chapter.
可能有一些人神正在预备你进入到一个
新的篇章 I do not know who you are.
我不知道你是谁
Some, I know lah, but most of them I do not know.
但大部分人我可能不知道你们是谁
But as I was preparing this message, I didn't intend for this message.Actually,
其实当我在预备这个今天的讲道的时候，我并没有想跟大家讲这边的信息。
God just reminded me this word stubbornness.
但是神就一直在提醒我这个词固执。
Stubbornness.
固执。
I need to share about this word stubbornness.
我今天早上跟大家分享的东西就是关于固执的。
And I look at my wife. Ah, you also very stubborn. Ayah, reminded me again. I must share about this.
所以我看到我太太，她也是非常的固执，让我要分享这个东西。
Thanks God, she's not here.
还好她今天早上不在。
But my point is.God is sharing something to you guys this morning.
但是我想讲的是，神今天早上想跟你分享一些的事情。
I do not know who you are.
我并不知道你是谁。
But if God is speaking to you,
但是如果神在对你讲话
，come before Him in humbleness.
来到神的面前，谦卑的来到神的面前。
Seek Him and trust Him.
寻求他，相信他。
Instead of having impatience, trust in Him.
而不是有那种没有的耐心，而是你去相信神。
Believe that He has a great plan for you.
你相信神对你有一个大计划。
Because you have seen the goodness that He has planned out for you throughout your life, right? Up to this point.
因为你在生命当中，你很多的时候，你看到神所为你预备的。
Trust in Him.
相信他。
Shall we all pray?
让我们一起来祷告。
Let's all just prepare our hearts this morning.
让我们预备我们的心，今天早上。
We are not rushing anywhere this morning.
我们并不紧张。
Because the presence of God is here right now.
因为神的同在。
And I just want to pray for you guys.
今天早上想为你们祷告。
Thank you, Jesus. Let's wait upon the Lord just a bit moment.
让我们来静静的等候神。
Thank you, Jesus.
感谢神。
Thank you, Lord. No one looking on your left or your right. If anyone that you feel that God is speaking to you, maybe you can just put your hands on your heart and say, God, I want you to change me.
不用看你的左边，也不用看你的右边。如果你真的希望神可以改变你的时候，把你的手放在你的心口，告诉神，神啊，我希望你能够改变我。
I want you to humble me.
我希望你可以让我谦卑。
I want you to teach me to walk to fear you, Lord.
我希望让你教导我，我可以在我的生活当中，主要可以进。
No longer I want to be stumble, Lord.
我不再是那一个固执的人。
No longer I do not want to be a stubborn person.
我不想再成为一个固执的人。
I do not want to go back to point A again, Lord. I want you to bring me to another level, Lord. Lord, help me. I want to truly trust in you. Teach me to fear you, Lord. Teach me to be good, Lord, to trust in you. God, help me to learn to love you. Help me to learn to be obedient before you. Help me to serve you with all my heart and with all my soul, Lord. Help me, Lord, that I be able to observe your ways, Lord. So that I can bow before you, Lord. And I can say, God, I trust.
神啊,
I trust you with all my heart. That all these things that you have given me is good and amen. If you are that person, I will go to pray for you right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Let's wait a bit more. Let's just quiet down our hearts. We are not rushing anyway. You know, I saw your hand. I saw many of your hands you put in your heart. God is speaking to us this morning. Father, this morning, Lord, I just want to pray for my brothers and sisters. Father, you help them, Lord. You speak to them, Lord. Father, you melt their stubbornness, Lord, in their heart. Lord, you remind them of the goodness that you have in their life. That how you have bring them up from Egypt, Lord. And you provide them and you have never put them in hunger or in thirst, Lord. That you have provided all the ways until right now. God, as they humble themselves before you, Lord, this morning, Lord. Father, may your love be with them, Lord. May your peace be with them, Lord. Father, may you take away your angers, Lord, and you give them shalom and peace, Lord. May your love fill them up again right now. In Jesus' most precious and most wonderful name, amen.